Hello and welcome to Sevtech Ages. My name is Whisperfire, and as you could see, I traveled all the way up north on the map to the Shoggoth layer and discovered that it is defunct. It is not working. And I wanted to show this on camera to show that this is a common problem with Sevtech. This is running 3.0.6, and basically what happens is that this right here is supposed to be Shoggoth ooze. Yeah, some kind of bio gel ooze. And when you first load it, the Shoggoth are here and they spawn. And basically when you leave the chunk and it becomes unloaded, that hardens and becomes monolith stone, and thus preventing the Shoggoth from spawning. So I went ahead and took advantage and gathered a lot of monolith stone. So I took out the ceiling and the walls and lit it up a little bit. Now let me show you how you can breathe life into the Shoggoth lair. Okay, it uses this Shoggoth biomass, and basically you need to have admin or single player, and you just simply plant some into your inventory like that. And we have to work quick, but this Shoggoth biomass is what's going to cause the Shoggoth to spawn. So we gotta be very quick about it and deposit all of this biomass. And let's see about getting rid of all of it, planting all of it down. And this should cause the Shoggoth to spawn. Now, I don't think it's affected by light levels. As you could tell, they spawned right away. Woo. Anyway, this is the Shoggoth lair that we found in episode 2. So let's go ahead and turn this to true. Turn this to here to delete it. And let's turn that off. Now, I'm going to start the process of killing off the Shoggoth. And there are two ways to get the Shoggoth flesh, because that is what I'm trying to get, because I want to get these statues. And there are two ways to get it. One of them is you let the Shoggoth out and let 6 of them combine, and they eventually build a monolith and have a statue up on top. But that causes a huge mess. However, an alternative way is if we make these decorative statues, which I don't have access to the recipe just yet because we don't have a Necronomicon. But basically, you combine clay, abyssal stone, and a dye powder, and you make a decorative statue, which is a non-working version of it. And then you combine it with 8 Shoggoth flesh. And basically, oh, I'm not sure why this is not working. And basically, that's how you convert it and craft it into the actual statues. Is it me, or is this arrow thing not working? We got 4 shots left. It's reflecting back. Oh, they're immune to these arrow shots. Gotcha. Anyway, what I've chosen to do is simply cage off the area because they are too wide creature. And basically, I'm just going to farm them and kill them here. And the version of Sevtech that I'm playing, it says, according to the patch notes, that it guarantees 3 Shoggoth flesh per drop. So I'm kind of banking on that. So let's go ahead and get these Shoggoth. Do a little bit of farming. My goal is to get 64, a full stack of Shoggoth flesh, because I want to get 8 statues. So let me go ahead and continue on with this, and I'll meet you back at the base and we will start Abyssalcraft. There. Nice and neat. I highly recommend using this technique over just letting them loose in the world and causing a lot of mess. But, yeah, this is a very effective way of getting Shoggoth flesh. Anyway, let me wrap up here. I'm gonna also take advantage and gather some of the brown mushrooms so we can make hearty stew. And, I will meet you back at the house. Okay, we are back home and we got a lot of stuff to craft. So, I gathered up all the inventory that we need, at least to get started. I eventually want to get energy collectors, relays, and energy containers to help kind of like advance our Abyssalcraft section, but I don't have the room in my inventory to put that stuff. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to make a Necronomicon, because a lot of the recipes are blanked out. So we're going to take the plant twine, make it into cloth, and with the Necronomicon, I don't have enough Corallium flesh, but we got Corallium plagued flesh on a bone. We just put it to a work blade, and there, we got some bone, and we got our knife back. So, let's make ourselves a Necronomicon. All right, so we got Abyssal crafted. So now the other rituals that include making an energy relay, collector, and storage should now be unlocked in JEI. So let's go ahead and take a look at what we need. Let's see. We're going to need the statues. So we're going to make the decorative Cthulhu statue. We're going to make two of those. We're going to make the decorative Hester statue. And then, let's see, Jahazar. Yep, we're going to represent the old gods. Azeroth. Okay. And Gnarlartip. I'm probably butchering the names of these gods. Yog-Shoggoth. Alright, so we got that. And the decorative Niggurath. Alright, so right now these decorative statues do nothing, but if we wrap it around with Corallium flesh, we turn it into an actual living statue. So we're going to go ahead and just simply make all of our statues, change them from decorative, and we got 8 statues. We got all of the gods right here. So we got that. Now we need an energy pedestal. So I think, let's take a look. Energy pedestal. Energy pedestal. There we go. We got ourselves an energy pedestal, and then we are going to make some monolith stones. We're gonna need some more. We're gonna need some more monolith stone. Okay, so we just need 4 more. Okay, so next is the beneath porter. We need a blank porter, and we need that tier 2 blood orb, which we got right here. Let's go ahead and get an empty hand right there. Alright, so we got the tier 2 blood orb, and let's see, that's gonna be this and that, some black dye powder, the Corallium pearl, the block of coal. Let's see if I remember this recipe. Nope, that's not how you do it. Ah, there it is, blank porter. Okay. So we'll go ahead and take this and put it back. Then we need to make a fence gate. Okay. So we got the ingredients to make a pedestal and to make a beneath transporter. So let's go ahead and put our stuff away. All right. And, oh, and blank transporter. And we'll take this blood orb, put it here. Okay, now let's take a look at some of the other things that we need to craft. Let's see. Alright, for the beneath portal, we need 4 monolith stone. So, that's 4 of these, if I can get mouse tweaks to work. Okay. Then, let's see. What else do we need? Let's go ahead and go through the list. An energy collector. So we're gonna need some of this, some of that. Let's see, energy collector, relay. Ooh, the relay is not available. Energy relay. Alright, so we're gonna need some shards. Alright, let's grab that. Alright, and energy container. That requires another energy pedestal, so I think we're gonna need some of this. Okay. So let's think. Energy pedestal, collector, relay. I think that's it. So let's take a look. Alright. Kinda hard to read JEI, but let's see. Energy collector. We got one for ourselves. Now for the energy container, that's a ritual that requires an energy pedestal and some shards and 4 more energy collectors. Okay, so let's plan this out. We're gonna need 4 more of these. Okay, whew, burning through my my gems. Okay, and we're gonna need another pedestal. So that's gonna be this one. So we're gonna need another pedestal. Okay, so we got the collector, the relay, and let's see, overworld relay, energy relay. We need 2 of them, I think? Yeah, I think we need 2 of them. Okay, now let's look into upgrading these. Let's see, what's the recipe? That's 2 cobblestone, some corallium, and some shards. And some dark stone cobblestone. Okay. So, let's see. We can put this back. We can take... Well, we still need 4 monolith stone. Okay. Ah! Freaking mouse tweaks. Freaking mouse tweaks. Okay. Dark stone. Corallium gem. I'm just simply gonna grab it in bulk. And cobblestone. Let's see, what else did we need? Cobblestone, dark stone, shards. All right, do we have the shards? We have the shards. Okay, so I don't think we need that anymore. So let's empty out our inventory just a scooch. Okay. Woo! Okay, so I think we got enough for an upgrade. Let's grab some building blocks because we're gonna need to pillar our way up. Okay, so heading back to the abyssal place. Alright, let's go for a ride on our horse. There we go. Whee! We get to go for a ride on the horsey. Okay. So we got quite a bit of crafting to do, including getting set up for the deep, not the deep dark, the beneath. I get those two mixed up. So the beneath. Do 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 do. And I'm thinking about leaving the beneath teleporter here. Okay, so. Let's go ahead and take our leave for the horse. Put him right here. Now, I went down into the Abyssal Darklands. And down at, like, diamond level, which is, like, Y12 or so, I was able to get this Abyssalcraft Dark Stone. And we have it in our layout right here. So, if we do rituals, information, getting started... We got the blocks that we can use, and it shows us how to lay it out. So we got it all set up. And then we shift right click the altar with the Necronomicon. Okay, shift. Nice. Right click. Okay. Now, let's head down here into our, gonna be where we're gonna put our statues. I renovated a little bit, added punji sticks and monolith stone so that we don't have to clean up the Shoggoth goos. And I put the punji sticks like underneath the slabs right up there so that any Shoggoth that get away, well, we got them cornered. We got their number. So we're gonna put these pillars here, and they can't be directly next to each other like that. They won't work. They have to be at least a block apart from each other and two blocks from the center. So we're gonna put our pillars here, and then our statues. Okay, we got two Cthulhu. So let's take one of the energy pedestals for now. Place it here, place our Necronomicon. All right. Then let's go ahead and take these statues, take the Cthulhu. Yeah, Cthulhu's cute. All right, and then we just put these guys wherever. Okay, come on. Ship Niggeroth. All right. Now that's Corellium. Yog-Sogoth. Jahazar. Hastir, Azeroth, Nalartip. Okay, so we don't want to stay near this altar for too long. Ouch. Because lightning will strike, mobs will spawn. So let's go ahead and get a healthy distance away. Wait for that to charge up, and then we'll go ahead and start on our rituals. Wow, that was trippy. Lightning bolts, mob spawns, wither effect, everything. And it stopped oozing out projectiles, so I think it's full. Yeah, I think it's full. So let's get down here. Oops, bounce. Grab our Necronomicon, and it's 5,000. Okay, it's full. Let's grab this energy pedestal. Alright, and while waiting, I kind of did the math, and it turns out that I had to make two more relays, because their base value is that they move energy by 4 blocks. Their upgraded version goes up by 6, and 2 times 6 does not equal 20. So I had to make some more energy relays. So let's go about upgrading our stuff. Okay, and this one has 0, that one has 5,000. So let's see. First thing on upgrading is the energy collector, I think. Yeah. Okay, so let's grab one of these. Alright, and then we'll put that in the middle. This is gonna be our first ritual. So let's, ooh, our bags are full. Yeah, I'm all ready and prepared to go for the beneath in the next episode. I've already made plans to jump ahead and just immediately just do bam, 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 do a double recording. Okay, so I think. Let's see. Shadow Gem Shards. So, let's see, that's the Darkstone, Cobblestone, Corellium. So, if I understand this correctly, we're going to need two of each, and it doesn't matter if it's symmetrical or not. It will still work, at least from what I've heard. So, I'm going to take their word for it. Now, there's a chance that the ritual may fail if I leave the circle or move too far away. So we have to be in or near the circle, which means we're gonna get zapped. Okay, here goes the ritual. So I shift and... creepy. And bam. Okay, so we got our first item, and grab the pickaxe, kind of move everything down. Okay, so let's grab this. And we got our first upgraded item. Alright, so let's go ahead and upgrade the energy pedestal. So, let's take a look. So, I think the pedestal, let's see, overworld energy pedestal, it's the same recipe. And that's two of each. One, two, one, two. Okay. So, let's try it here. Kind of stay put. It's draining the potential energy out of the Necronomicon. And... ouch. We got our upgraded pedestal. Okay. So, that's another item. Alright. Next one, I believe, is the energy relays. So, we need to do this 4 times. Yeah. You know, let's do the collector. Alright, so that would be the energy collector. Alright, so to make the energy collector, we need this in the middle. We need 4 of these. And 4 of these. Okay. And bam!
Cluster.
Ooh, creepy. This is gonna... please don't fail. Okay. Got that. Put that back. And we need 2 of each. Alright. 2. And I am a bit of a wuss. I'm sleeping. Yeah. Don't want any mobs to spawn. I am a big wuss. Yes, I admit it. I'm a big wuss. Okay, so let's upgrade this baby. Get our energy relays. Youch. Okay, so far so good. We are doing good. So let's do the assembly line. Okay. Here we go. And, oh! Get back here. And shift. Bam. Wow. This is just freaky. Ooh. Okay, and ouch. Okay, so let's do this 3 more times. Okay, so we got our stuff upgraded. Let's do the overworld. Well, not the overworld, but the beneath ritual. So we're gonna need this, and 4 of these. Oh. And this. So, we're gonna take that and take the odd items. Got everything here. Doing good so far. Okay, and this is gonna hurt. Yep, it's gonna hurt. Here we go. Youch. And we got ourselves a beneath teleporter. We're gonna put that there. We're gonna save that for next episode. But we are going to set up the inner workings of our Abyssalcraft thing. So before we get started, let's take these statues down so they don't zap us, you know, while we're trying to work. Last thing we want is to have an unexpected spawn, you know? Okay. Okay. And these are kind of hard to remove. Yeah. Alright, so. This place should be inert. And we have... okay, we have all of the statues. So. if I understand this correctly, we need the pedestal, the energy collector here. And you know what? I'm going to replace this. This looks kind of ugly. We got our positions already situated. So let's go ahead and I would say purtify it or beautify it, but this place is not pretty. But it kind of bothered me, you know? It kind of bothered me. Alright, so we'll just touch it up just a little bit. And one more. Oops. I know, I'm a derp. Okay, so we got the energy collector. Now, let's see if I understand this correctly. We're gonna need the relay. And we're gonna place the relay, actually, let's put this one block higher. I saw Asgard do this and it works just fine. So, we will take this, pillar our way up. We'll need one energy relay and the energy container here. And he put another relay, but he didn't dig his pit straight down. So let's see, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So let's go ahead and put our marker here for the 6th one. And we will get rid of that. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, that should work. Alright, and if we place a block, not there, there. Alright, so if this is to work out the way I am hoping. Alright, so we're gonna need our shovel. And this should work out. Okay, so we got 5 blocks, 5 blocks. Something tells me that this is going to be a little off. So let's see. That was 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, let's move you up by 1. Oops, you fell. Yeah, Derp City. Okay. Man, I wish I had Vein Miner. Okay. And down here. Ah, heck with it. Okay, so. So that would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And we put the relay there. Alright. Let's get rid of some of the dirt. Clear it out. Ooh, don't like mess. Boink, 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 boink. What am I doing? Dilly-dallying. Okay. And no. Okay. And then all right. So that would be 1, 2. All right. Let's bring you up. All right. We got it in our inventory. That was 1, 2. Yeah, it's 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Oh well. We'll just use this. Alright, so we'll just place that there. Clean up our mess here. I'll just slap that there. Work our way back down. You know, it's kind of strange in how dirt sometimes gives you a flint, you know? Alright, that should be it. Okay. Ooh. That's a long way. It is a long way. But hopefully we get this nice and set up. Okay, so, alright, let's take our overworld pedestal. Place you here. I guess it's alright if you're one block up. Place our Necronomicon. And back down we go. Whee! Ouch. Wow. That hurt. That hurt. Okay. So, let's go ahead and put our statues back. That's Hestir, Nalotep, Shibnigaroth, and it is projecting a energy. Yogg-Sothoth, Azeroth, Cthulhu. Ooh, ouch. And Cthulhu. Ouch. And we should be good, right? All right. It's collecting up in that. And that should shoot up the energy. Yeah, I think it will work. I think it will work. Woo! Okay. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to clean up the inventory. And then, next episode, we are going to the beneath. Yeah, we are going to the beneath. But, I hope you guys enjoyed yourself on this episode. We got a nice setup going here. It's nice and safe, though it's a bit risky. So anyway, be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and share. This has been Whisperfire, and I wish you an awesome day. Oh yeah. You wanna play? Oh, you wanna play? Here my pickaxe.